inkling at that time that, hey, those guys are pretty good?
Yeah, I think that I thought they'd be terrific. We played them the three previous years, and I'm really happy that they won today. Bob and I have got a great friendship, and we talked quite a bit, and I was extremely happy for the team. But I thought they would be very good, and they're obviously senior-laden and well-coached, and those kids deserve every bit of success that they're having.
They came here for the game last year with the elementary school kids, right? Were they here in the morning?
Man, I can't remember that. I'd hate to tell you that I can't remember that far back.
Want to schedule them again? Now a good time to schedule them. Maybe
you know, we'd like to. He'd like to play again. Just finding a time that fits and a place. And we've discussed some different options, so it's a possibility.
Well, your team's kind of getting to that situation. Are y'all going to be a lot of upperclassmen that you're like Mercer was this year? I mean, just how much that kind of thing, you know, obviously helps the squad.
Well, one of the goals we've had is to eventually have an older team. You know, and when you have an older team and an experienced team, you know, it works to your advantage. And we've not really had that just because of early entries. You know, we haven't really had a lot of that, but we're getting closer, and hopefully next year we'll have a stronger flavor of that experience.
You've had a chance to look at La Tech now. I've looked at them just a little bit. The first thing I wonder is how those guys aren't in the NCAA tournament, right? I mean,
well, they're terrific. There's no everyone playing now is good, and they're very good. A lot of interchangeable parts. Shooting the three all over the place. A lot of guys who can score. Good defensive team, forcing turnovers. I mean, they're an excellent team, and arguably a team that probably came down to the bitter end on whether they got in or not.
With the up-tempo style they have and also with their ability to get steals, that kind of thing, what kind of matchup is it for you? You guys kind of win a different way.
We've tried. We want to play as fast as we can always. We just don't want to play faster than we can play well. I think that this is a game in which, we can't play like we did the other night. We won the game the other night because our crowd picked us up and we kind of dug back in and made a few plays. But, we got to pass and catch it cleaner. We've got to defend much better. We've got to get back on the glass. I mean, we've got to do a lot of things to win because they're very, very good.
Speaking of playing faster than you can well, was that a problem for Charles the other night?
Seven
turnovers, and a lot of them.
He just dribbled the ball off his knee one time. I mean, he had a ball. He just caught it and dropped it on the other side. I mean, I think Charles just probably, mentally was not as dialed in early. I don't think it was a product of anything else other than just a little bit careless ball handling.
You tell your guys to, like, set two alarms tonight or something with this, Liv?
No, we have a morning breakfast every day, so we force them to get up. So that shouldn't be an issue for us. But getting after at 11 a.m., that's not something we've done before.
Was it maybe like a good learning experience for the team to face that adversity against Vermont, and then now, you're in tournament time? So
I think it was a great experience for us. I think the more we play, the more experiences we can have, the better we'll be in the long run. I think it was a great experience. I think it was good for us to fall behind and have to fight back. I think it was good for our crowd to have to fight for us. I mean, I think there's a lot of pluses from that game. But we also have to understand, how we got in that hole, and we can't repeat that behavior.